this government has been playing with fire because they are bringing divisive agendas before parliament, passing divisive agendas, not allowing matters to be discussed fully in select committees. They did it with Notbandi. You know, one at midnight they announced something, not realizing the consequences, and the economy is where it is today. They did it with GST without listening to the sane advice of the Congress Party that you can't have a multi-rate GST. They've done it with Kashmir. They said, look, everything is normal in Kashmir. We know for a fact that nothing is normal in Kashmir. And now they've done it to the Northeast. Northeast is burning. The BJP members, MLAs, are being attacked. There is an army flag march. The Chief Minister's house is almost under siege. Now, these things should not happen in a democracy, but a wise government and wise leadership always ensures that bills are passed in a manner that will satisfy everyone. Before you pass the bill, you must take people on board. But this government doesn't believe in that because it thinks it has absolute majority. It thinks that it can persuade parties who are ideologically opposed to these bills, yet vote for them for reasons that they know. And they think that, therefore, once a bill is passed, everything is normal. In fact, it is not. Normality comes from wisdom, not from passing bills.
The mischievous statements which were made by Mr. Rahul Gandhi yesterday tend to fish in the troubled waters of Brahmaputra, and they are trying to seek the crutches of some of the disgruntled elements to revive their fortunes, but this is not going to happen. Maybe in certain sections there is lack of understanding, but as our workers, our karyakartas and all the colleagues are trying to educate the masses about the actual facts about the bill, I think gradually the things are steadily coming back to normalcy, because the bill is not going to, the new law is not going to affect anybody adversely. So an unnecessary misgiving has sought to be created by certain vested interests. Our members of parliament, our elected representatives from the region are very much in contact with the masses, and whoever is protesting also is a part of our constituency and our own people, even including those in the tea gardens. And I would, through you, appeal that there is nothing to fear, and if at all some kind of a protest has happened from some quarter, the people who went on protest also belong to us, and they will be adequately taken care of. Their interests would be watched.